assortment of birds. I guess some are peacocks. This is Bourbon Street. Restaurants, bars. There's Albert's Lounge, there's Tony Rima's and Zambelli's, Cafe New Orleans. Tootsie's. Steak and Suds. There's a mother. The submarines travel through. There's the old pirate ship sitting there. There's kind of an animal underwater down there that the sub would see. There's a submarine right there. There's another one just starting out. Let's see if they get another wave here. Here it comes. It's like being in Waikiki. the submarine. There's one waiting to come in. Lower the gate or the ramp and then open the door. If it ever sail, it sure looks like it would. Okay, it's 11:38 in the morning, Friday, the 3rd. We're going into Waterton Park, which is on the backside, the north end of Glacier Park. It's a Canadian inn. Same time, same place. There's a nice, beautiful hawk sitting right there. A little bit drizzly. Very, very funny country here at the plains, these funny gullies they've got here. They got these things they call coulee, C-O-U-L-E-E. They're like little valleys that run through the flatland. Might have a little stream running through the bottom. We're up about 4,500 foot. My body's getting all wet standing here. Okay, we're in Waterton Park. It's going to be very, very difficult to show what there is here because it's just so close and so magnificent. There's the road coming in. Waterton Lake, the south, one end of it, north end of it, I guess it is. The mountains in the background. I guess it's Prince George Hotel or something like that. Just no matter where you look, mountain after mountain. We're going to drive down to the town site now and see what's down there. Here's a better shot of the hotel. Only got 81 rooms, but my grandeur of it. Now this is the little town of whatever it is. The park. Another shot of the hotel.
Well, it's still July 3rd, a Friday. We left our campground this morning because it was so depressing, rainy, muddy, and decided to take the ride to Waterton, which is part of the International Glacier Peace National Park, the Canadian portion. I believe this is McDonald Lake, and what you're seeing is the Canadian Rockies and Mr. Sherman Vollans. And of course, the Alpine Prince of Wales Hotel. Very, very pretty. Very pretty. Of course, I'm down in the valley looking up. I'm glad we came on a Friday instead of a Saturday. It's not really crowded, but I guess I just like to have the whole park to myself. Where did Dad go? Dad, you gonna get in the picture?
I already did, didn't I?
No, right. There he is. Still a smart ass. Oh, it's about 15 minutes later and we're still at Waterton National Park. I don't know if it's going to catch the beauty, but we'll try. Tree-covered mountains. And then you see the peak of just a rugged, uncovered mountain. Well, maybe about 3 minutes later, stopped, take this picture. I don't know if I mentioned this is called Red Canyon Road. And maybe this explains why the red rock. Some pictures of the wildflowers. It grows all along the road. Daisies. Some other color yellow flower.
Thanks.
believe it, sure.
Honest to God, I don't know about these people. Stupid-ass son of a...
Well, look at that.
Mule deer. You speak of grandeur. Take a look. Beautiful, hey what? As we're proceeding back down the road, there's a campground you'd like, Lee. Right in the heart of the mountains. No services, quiet, lots of wild animals.
So here's the KOA in Harver, Montana. Had a little shower about an hour ago. They had about 6-8 inches of rain here last night. They were busy all day working with pumps trying to drain the campground, and just got hit with another terrible one. Here's part of 1,500 trees they just planted. Don't give them too much chance. Look closely in there. You'll see Ma. She won't put her boots on and come out. She thinks it's too deep, but it's not bad.
I want you to move that platform closer to the door.
We got a raft that we had as a doorstep. Kind of floated away. I'll have to go get it. Funny color, funny country here. Fortunately, the campground is a little bit high on that end. Help drain everything down towards us here and out towards the gate. Couple over there had their tent pitched, all set up nice. The river flowed right through it. Everybody's coming out. I just counted 4 guys out here with video cameras. Here's the campground owner. He's bussing people around trying to get them through the flood. Here we go, up the Lake of the Clouds. Beautiful sunny day and raining a little bit. Can't even tell you what the date is. What's the date today? About July 11th. Yeah, there's this ski tower down by Bessemer someplace where we got the trailer. And it's Lake of the Clouds.
It
should take me from...
Yes, well, this close she's going to get to the wall. She did get this close enough that she could see Lake of the Clouds down there.
Chicken, 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 chicken.
The end of the adventure. 11,100 miles by truck. 1,000 miles by boat. Another 600 by train and by car. Come on, through a rainstorm. Can't unload the truck yet. Can't unload the trailer. Can't cut the grass. It's flooding. Front lawn looks like, well, I hardly know what to call it. It's a weed bed. There's a little bit of grass growing in there someplace. We'll have to look around and find it. There's our garden. What's left? There's sheepy that somebody tore up. Some kind of an animal got in there. Here's the backyard. The trumpet vines are actually pushing the patio blocks up. It's a monster. Got shoots coming up all over the place. The grass has been cut. That's what we contracted for. Patio is going to require a little bit of work, I think. Well, I dare go out there. I might get involved in some weed. Never get away. Over the fence, which just need a little trimming. Blue spruce looks better than ever. Red maple. We'll survive.